Escort on either side of the gun carriage, formed by 1st Battalion Grenadier Guards. You'll notice that their arms are reversed. The swords are turned backwards. The rifles turned back with the left arm to hold the muzzle down, all as an act of respect for the late Queen. garrison sergeant major. Mr. Stokes, who has been preparing these soldiers, leads the king and his siblings and other members of the royal family. And in the rear rank of that family, the Earl of Snowdon and the Duke of Gloucester. Scarlet tunics of the dismounted lifeguards from the Household Cavalry Regiment, leading this parade as the senior regiment of the British Army. From the end where Buckingham Palace stands by the great statue of Queen Victoria, one late sovereign watches our latest departed queen make her way towards Westminster, the heart of the nation's constitution. Surmise that the late Queen would most have her interest in the horses taking part after a lifetime loving anything equestrian. She made the point that the King's troop who convey her now with their horses and their gun carriage would keep the name her father had given of King's Troop Royal Horse Artillery. They held that title all through her reign. And now we have a new king. At the centre of the imperial state crown, there are four pearl earrings that hang from the arches where they cross. These are supposed to have come from Scotland and to have been worn once by Mary, Queen of Scots. Thank you. sapphire in the cross at the top, supposedly taken from the ring finger of King Edward the Confessor when his coffin was translated from one part of Westminster Abbey to the other by King Henry III in the 1200s. I'm watching with eminent pride as their daughter passes by, Queen Elizabeth, the Queen Mother, as we remember her, and King George VI.